Blackstone presents The Henhouse Roof by P.D. Watts. This book is read by P.D. Watts.
In the process of completing Echoes, which I shall now recite, I reached the conclusion that I had sown the seeds of the novel that is to follow. Echoes. So shall I walk among the trees, upon the earth, beneath the skies, to listen for the echoes of my life. What made me feel the elemental force, at odds with time, yet friend of nature's seasons too, and yet to breathe alone? How can each fleeting summer day caress my soul, cause wonderlands of mind to dance and sing, yet leave that soul alone? Unpruned the rambling forties rose, beside the fence and elder tree, my ladder to the henhouse roof, the kingdom that belonged to me those years ago. From there, a harbour in the sun, a life set sail across its day, in blissful ignorance of pain, atrocity so far away those fears ago. Horse and cart in slow village lane, where youth was young and longed for more, my golden double summertime brought darkness to the house next door those tears ago. Powdered milk from a ration book, piston-engined moons at night, home fires warming distant hearts, the thunder red of London light, those miles away. So much given by the unseen few, whose lives set sail across my sky, as buttercups and dew-mown hay drenched me with life, while they would die, those sighs away. I watch their passing vapour trails make timeless patterns in my head, print bold the memories of youth, the sky now clear, the printers dead, those lives away. Now gone the rambling forties rose, now past the fence and elder tree, no ladder to a henhouse roof, yet still it all belongs to me. Why do I conjure images of phantom worlds? Images that may shine forever on the page of stars, yet leave this man alone. I, this child of dust, this man alone, needs therefore walk among the trees, upon the earth, beneath the skies, to listen for the echoes of my life. The novel is a story of family loyalties and a man's undying love for a beautiful young woman, a novelist, Emily Lorenzo de Pasquale, who is kidnapped and sexually assaulted in Los Angeles on a professional visit with her agent, subsequently failing to recover from giving birth to the rapist's child. Born in a quiet English village, shortly before the onset of the Second World War, Simon Brand's life is quickly and inextricably interwoven with the Clare-Thompson family and their country estate, which borders the village. His mother moves them away from the village after the war, and an honours degree in economics at Cambridge sees him opting for what proves to be an outstanding career as a business financial consultant in the city. At the end of a day of goodbyes in Cambridge, his eyes meet those of an extraordinarily beautiful young woman through the window of a bus. They smile at each other as their buses depart, and having failed to find her in the days and weeks that follow, he begins to fear their paths may never cross again. He dreams about her, and Emily Lorenzo de Pasquale becomes an absent but essential part of his life. Later, finding himself called upon to lead a bid to save the Clare-Thompson family company, they eventually meet. The tragic events that follow prompt his subsequent actions and colour his attitudes for the rest of his life. The Henhouse Roof, a novel written and narrated by P.D. Watts. Prologue.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.